Hello, welcome to Back to Coding. For better understanding of this video, I highly recommend you to check out the previous video or the complete playlist in the description below. Today I'll be talking about how to read a record from a cursor and navigate through it. Before we get started, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and bell icon so that whenever I publish a video, you get notified instantly about it. We have now seen how to create a cursor. We use the SQLite database query method to say what data you want the cursor to return. But that's not the end of the story, we need to read values from it. Whenever we need to retrieve values from a particular record in a cursor, you first need to navigate to that record. You need to do this irrespective of how many records are written by the cursor. You specify what records you want by creating a query on the database. The cursor contains the records described by the query. We need to move to a record in the cursor to read values from it. Now we'll look at how to navigate cursors. There are four main methods you use to navigate through the records in a cursor. These methods are moveToFirst, moveToLast, moveToPrevious and moveToNext. To get access to the first record written by the cursor, you can use its moveToFirst method. It returns a value of true if it finds a record, and false if the cursor hasn't returned any records. Move to the first row. If you want to navigate to the last record written by the cursor, you can use the moveToLast method instead. Just like the moveToFirst method, it returns a value of true if it finds a record and false if it doesn't. Move to the last row. To iterate through the records in the cursor, you use the moveToPrevious and moveToNext methods. The moveToPrevious method moves you to the previous record in the cursor. It returns true if it succeeds in moving to the previous record and false if it fails, which could be because it's already at the first record or because the cursor doesn't contain any records. Move to the previous one. The move to next method works in the same way as the move to previous method, except that it moves you to the next record in the cursor. It returns true if it succeeds in moving to the next record and false if it fails. Move to the next row. Once we have navigated to a record in our cursor, we can access its value. We'll see that in the next video. Don't forget to check my other videos, which can be helpful to you.